Hello there! Today, I am explaining my cinematic lighting and techniques in Unreal Engine for one of my projects. I am here to guide you through these Unreal Engine lighting methods. I am Mohamed Soleil, the creative director, 3D artist, and founder of Soleil Animation. I will share my creative journey through this YouTube channel, offering tips and insights. Please subscribe and like for more content. For one of my projects, I needed a forest background. I used the Electric Dreams environment from the Unreal Engine Marketplace to streamline the process. This project includes a level called Electric Dreams PCG Forest. PCG stands for Procedural Content Generation, allowing easy modifications to create a unique forest setting by altering parameters. In this project, I wanted to utilize sublevels for each lighting scenario. Although this feature was initially disabled, I enabled it by copying everything from the outliner into a new empty level. However, I noticed the landscape didn't transfer, so I generated a new landscape and applied the material from the original. We'll start by cleaning up the outliner. Once set up, we'll find a location, create a camera, and if you like, animate it using a level sequencer. I have already selected a view and animated the camera. I've created various sublevels and assigned them to the main level, using each for a different lighting scenario. We'll examine three levels of lighting: L1, main lighting, L2, cinematic touch, and L3, action and characters. Initially, we'll remove all existing lighting and start from scratch with sublevel lighting version 1 selected. We'll begin with basic lighting using the environment light mixer to create skylights, atmospheric lights, volumetric clouds, and more. This foundational system in Unreal Engine is quite powerful. Before adjusting our lighting, addressing the exposure settings across all setups is crucial. Unreal Engine defaults to automatic exposure control, which adjusts brightness based on location lighting. This means if you go somewhere brighter, it will reduce exposure. In a darker place, it will increase exposure. However, we'll deactivate this feature using a post-process volume for precise lighting control. Be sure to add the A post-process volume to the main level so it affects all the sublevels. After putting the post-process volume, you notice that it comes with boundaries. However, on its detail, type UNB, and we set it to infinite extent unbound to affect the entire scene. On the exposure section, activate metering mode and exposure compensation, then set minimum and maximum exposure levels to 0 for consistent exposure across the scene. Unreal Engine also includes built-in tone mapping, which will deactivate for more control over lighting and color. This is done in the color grading section of the post-process volume under Miscellaneous. We'll turn off a blue correction, expand gamut, and tone curve amount. This preparation allows for using external color correction software or lookup tables for final color grading. However, we can turn it back on when we are happy with our lighting. Let's turn off all the lights and then turn them back on one by one to explain the parameters of each. The first is the directional light, which is crucial as it imitates the sun. To adjust its direction, press Ctrl plus L on your keyboard, click anywhere in the scene, and position the light as you like. In the details section of the directional light, the most important parameters are intensity and light color. After that, the source angle is significant as it determines the size of the light source, such as the sun. Smaller sources result in sharper shadows, while larger sources create softer shadows, which is important for different scenarios. Another essential setting in directional light is indirect light intensity, which controls the secondary bounce of light. It indicates how many times light bounces between objects, brightening darker areas with more bounces. Moving on to the sky atmosphere. In its details, you can adjust various parameters to simulate a sky. Skylight is also crucial, combining all elements in the scene and projecting them back, unifying the lighting. The key parameter in skylight is the intensity scale, which determines the brightness of the projected image. Increasing it brightens the scene. Real-time capture ensures that changes in location or direction work seamlessly together. However, you can also use another image source, like an HDR, by deactivating real-time capture. The next item is the exponential height fog. Important parameters here include fog intensity, fog height fall off, and fog scattering color, which affect the fog's appearance. Start distance determines how far you start seeing the fog. Adjust these parameters based on your artistic choices. Volumetric clouds are the final element, offering cloud system options. Enable these elements to see how they interact. Adjust these parameters based on your artistic choices. After setting up the lighting, you can activate the tuning map to see the final image color. Let's go through the process one more time, but this time let's exclude the volumetric clouds to have a clear view of the sun in the sky. I've found a great direction for the sun, and I love seeing it behind those branches. So I increased the source angle, which indicates the size of the light source, in this case our sun. I increased the intensity scale to 2 to brighten up darker areas in the skylight details. I'm now enabling volumetric fog in exponential height fog, which is an exciting feature. It allows directional light and other light sources to interact with the fog. You can adjust the intensity to control the level of interaction. However, I prefer to set it directly in our light source. If you increase it here, it affects every light source in the scene, but adjusting it through the light source affects only that specific light source, which is very useful. Now, let's move on to level 2 lighting. In level 1, we established the main lighting. In level 2, we aim to enhance the cinematic touch by adding more light sources. I've added spotlights to increase the desired effect and make the scene more interesting. One helpful feature is the light mixer, which allows you to manage active lights efficiently. However, we already have a good setup in our outliner, but if you don't, you can find all your lights in the light mixer. It's essential to note that every added light affects the volumetric fog. We don't want any volumetric effects on these extra lights for cinematic purposes. Please select all of them, go to the details section, and set the volumetric scattering intensity to 0 to deactivate them. Once you're satisfied with the lighting, you can use the post-process volume to bring back the tone mapping and see the final look. Now, let's move on to the HDRI method. To use HDR, activate the HDRI plugins from the plugins menu. It may appear black when you place it in the scene, so you'll need to adjust its size and location. You can also change its intensity and rotation for different lighting effects. You can even switch to another HDRI image. After adding HDR, you'll need to add more lights, such as a directional light, to enhance highlights. Adjust the HDRI intensity and add fog as needed for level 2 lighting. Consider downloading HDRs from sources like Polyhaven to get the best results. Ensure you download them in HDR format. A 4K resolution should be good for our purposes. Once you've added the HDRI, make necessary adjustments such as changing MIPGen settings to no MIP maps and adjusting maximum texture size for optimal use of HDRI lighting. I applied the new HDRI to my scene and changed the intensity of the lights. I see if I can decrease the intensity of HDRI and I will have a better sky. However, I don't get enough lighting. HDRI backdrop detail shelf. There is a built-in skylight to increase skylight intensity built into your HDRI, so you get more of a brighter sky. Now, let's revisit the last method. In this method, as an art direct action for the scene, I had an image I wanted to use as my sky and be able to control the size of the stars. I found an HDRI matching my first image and applied it to a skylight. This allows me to control the brightness of the environment. I added a sky sphere from the content browser. After scaling it up, I changed its material to a simple material with the two-sided option activated. I applied a texture, adjusted brightness with a parameter, and assigned it to an emissive color. I also changed the tiling of the sky and made other necessary adjustments. Here's the final result. You may wonder why we didn't cover level 3 lighting. Level 3 is dedicated to action scenes. Stay tuned for updates on my channel, where I'll post the final work with the main character in the middle. Please like and subscribe if you like this video.